Right now, runners make it feel good. Just try and make it nice. Just gonna take out all the sharp edges because of the horse interferes. And by that I mean one leg will interfere with the movements of the other leg. I don't want any really sharp edges on the shoe because those sharp edges are what's gonna cause the horse to cut himself. There's a general rule about heels. It's usually two-thirds of the bevel on the inside of the shoe and one-third on the outside. That allows the dirt that builds up on the bottom of the horse's foot to clean out. If we just made it square and heel, the dirt and the bump shoes in the front would never clean out. And the horse would never clean out the dirt that's stuck in the bottom of his feet. It's a lot like when we get a piece of gravel in our shoe. We want to clean it out, but we just take our shoes off. The horse can't clean it, so we have help on it as much as possible.
So right now, she's got a wire brush in her hand. What exactly is that used for? Is she just cleaning up the shoes?
Well, there's an oxidation process that occurs inside the gorge where the oxygen that you need to burn the boat reacts with the steel. And we just refer to it as slag, but it's actually it's very similar to rust, whereas rust is a reaction between water and iron, and this is just oxygen and iron. We like to clean that off because when we're done, we're going to have a really nice smooth finish on the steel, and it doesn't matter much to the horse what that finish is like, but it's just a professional way of doing things. So she's building the quarter, and Bradley, is this a front or a hind shoe? It's a front shoe, so it's going to be more round than a hind shoe. The widest part of the front shoe is going to be about halfway between the toe and the heel. What Tyler has here in his left hand is a round shoe, and his right hand is the hind shoe. You can see the hind shoe is pointer at the toe, straighter at the corners. The heels are sharper, and there's the widest part is about two-thirds of the way, the distance from the toe to the heel. The difference in that, or the reason for the difference in that shape is that the horse bears two-thirds of his total body weight on the front feet and one-third on the back feet.
So I noticed on issue here, if we have something that sticks up in the front, what would this be used for?
What's a toe clip? So ideally, we would put the least number of nails in the horse's foot as possible. That's healthier for the horse's foot. We can keep a shoe on with six nails, we will. The shoe doesn't stay on with six, we'll go to seven nails, and then with eight. The shoe just still doesn't stay on, we'll put that toe clip on. What that toe clip does is prevents the shoe from twisting on the horse's foot. In a perfect world, the horse's foot would land perfectly flat on the ground, but the reality of it is that every time the horse's foot hits the ground, it's going to twist just a little bit. So if we can eliminate that twisting, we're going to keep the integrity of the nails. So a one-place clip is worth a couple extra nails without actually putting the nails in the horse's foot.
I see. So when you're able to shoot, like when you're able to, ideally, how many would, horses with the average fair your shoe would be. It looks like a lot of work, so I know myself, I would probably burn up pretty fast.
I'd say a comfortable day would be six full sets of shoes. Do 3 in the morning, take a lunch break. 3 in the afternoon, and still be in the afternoon. Right now, Riley's pritchling out the nail holes. And it's really important that the placement of the nail holes in the shoe is correct. We don't want any nails
to the toe.
We don't want any nails further back in the widest part of the horse's foot. The horse's foot naturally expands when it bears weight, and it's an anti-concussion device. And if we place nail holes further back in the widest part of the horse's foot, we limit that natural expansion of the horse's foot.
So I see she has a lot of tools, obviously, with different talents and hammers for different I guess built on the site, I guess, but so how many tools would average farrier carry?